Shotgun snap.
Oh, he's open. There he is.
Pass one across the middle. Yep. Pass is caught.
And there's a big swing by Huey. Blaine, stop that ball from coming over here.
I didn't see it coming back, Blaine.
Inside, like Coach Brookshire says. But Bernie with the rebound.
Steal.
He's running the last leg. That could be gold. And a gold.
And a gold.
Yeah, it's over.
In the third. Another one. There's another ground ball to shortstop, fielded by Herber, who fires it over to first base for out number three.
Oh, she got a hold of that one.
Maybe gone
by.
There
you go.
Wow. What a hit. That didn't take her long.
No.
Juan Galarza.
Welcome to another Billy's Live production. Find us on your favorite social sites and apps. Like, subscribe, and get notified when we go live.
Harrison's a sophomore, right?
Huh?
Sophomore, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Rivers a freshman.
Yeah.
All right, moms. Get those cannons ready. We're going to go on three. Three, two, one.
Uh-oh.
Once again, thank you. Please give these parents and players a big round of applause.
Hello, my name is Greg Nebgen with 4N Cattle Company. I want to talk to you a little bit about J4 trailer and my experience. So I was looking for a new cattle trailer, stopped by, talked to Josh, customized what I wanted. I own a local business. I want to do my business local. Prices were very competitive. I looked at trailers everywhere. They were $1,000 cheaper, if not more. I was going to buy local anyway. They beat everybody in price. And then they even delivered it. J4 trailer, that's where I got mine.
Top 5 reasons we love Gaddy's in Fredericksburg. Number 5, their student teacher lunch discount. Number 4, their all-you-can-eat buffet. Number 3, they have a huge variety of fresh veggies at the salad bar. Number 2, Gaddy's pasta and pizza is always hot and ready. And best of all, they even do the dishes. Gaddy's Pizza, Highway 16 South, across from the fairgrounds.
Security State Bank and Trust is a proud supporter of our local athletes. Whether it's on or off the field, game day or any day, they're here to help you succeed and tackle your financial goals. From personal and business banking to mortgage services or trust services, Security State Bank and Trust can support all your banking needs, helping build communities we call home since 1941. Security State Bank and Trust, proud sponsors of Battling Billy Sports. Let's go Billies! Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
It's grilling time at Hill Country Propane Inc., and we've got the latest models of stainless steel grills made in America. Our showroom is full of grills by Wilmington, AOG, Fire Magic, and Phoenix. We offer Primo ceramic grills and pellet grills by Smokin' Brothers. Summertime is the time to celebrate grilling for family and friends. Come on in today and let our experienced team demonstrate features of the grill you deserve. Hill Country Propane Inc., go propane.
Welcome to Creek Street Dental, where we strive to treat our patients with compassion, kindness, and care. We utilize the latest technologies in our commitment to your family, offering cone beam technology, cosmetic dentistry, and sedation dentistry so you can sleep through your appointment. Stop by and meet our newest addition, Dr. Monica Montgomery, from the Fredericksburg High School class of 2014. Creek Street Dental, on the corner of Creek Street and South Adams in Fredericksburg. Phone call to Bee Creek was all it took, and our speeds crazy fast. Bee Creek Communications, always on high speed internet.
Arrowhead Bank is celebrating 100 years of serving the Hill Country. Their goal is to greet you by name when you walk in the door and provide you the banking help you need today. You're guaranteed to speak to someone you know when you pick up the phone. Arrowhead Bank wants to thank all the employees of Fredericksburg ISD. Good luck to the Battling Billies in all activities this school year. Arrowhead Bank, 502 South Adams, 830-990-9300. Check them out online, arrowheadbanktexas.com.
All of us at FBG Live want to thank you for tuning in today. Lots of you have asked how you might support our video production. Well, if you want to grow your business, we know just the place to advertise. But here are three other super simple ways anyone can help. First of all, just tap the like button on this video. That helps us reach a broader audience, which in turn helps our sponsors who make it possible for you to watch. Secondly, subscribe to our channels and tap the notification bell so you get alerted whenever we go live. And finally, and most importantly, patronize our sponsors. Shop at their stores, enlist their services. Heck, if nothing else, just give them a call and tell them thank you for making it possible for you to watch today. It is a joy to serve our community through live video production, but we couldn't do it without you or without our sponsors. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Fredericksburg has put its confidence in Security State Bank and Trust for over 80 years. And now that same honesty and integrity is available for wealth management. We're not so much about timing the market, but time in the market. Not chasing returns, but capturing them. And not just for the affluent either. We're here to help anyone with their financial goals. A custom portfolio product based on your plan, your goals, your purpose. Give us a call today, 990-7750.
What is the FISD Education Foundation? Since our inauguration in 2018, the foundation has financially supported teachers and students from all our campuses achieve academic excellence. Our fundraising efforts help offset the adverse effects and depletion of resources brought on by state Robin Hood policies. Visit FISDKids.org to learn more. The FISD Education Foundation, partnering with our community because we're better together.
Arizola Plumbing, your full-service plumbing provider for the Fredericksburg community and beyond. We have the tools and experience for comprehensive residential and commercial plumbing, including everything from water filtration to drain services for new construction or even remodeling. Have an after-hours emergency? No problem. Don't settle for less than the best. We're online at arizolaplumbing.com or give us a call at 830-998-4336.
Hello friends, this is Shane Fronson from The Inside Story. We'd like to thank you, our Fredericksburg community, for trusting us with all your home decorating needs. Whether wood or tile floors, window treatments or wallpaper, vinyl plank or paint, for 43 years now, you've made us the number one rated store in the area, and we couldn't be prouder to back our Billies right here on Billies.Live. Thank you, Fredericksburg, for choosing The Inside Story. Drop by today and let us help make your house a home.
Thanks for tuning in, Billy Nation. Tonight's coverage is brought to you by The Inside Story, helping you make your house your home. Segner's Jewelers, with locations in Fredericksburg and Bee Cave. Hill Country Propane, for all your outdoor grilling needs. The FISD Education Foundation, let's make FISD better together. Security State Bank and Trust, celebrating 82 years of serving Fredericksburg.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Battling Billy Baseball Field here in Fredericksburg, Texas. I'm Peter Shandawa alongside Blaine Hahn here, bringing you the action tonight, 27-4A, between the Bandera Bulldogs and your Fredericksburg Battling Billies, who find themselves in fourth place currently. Bandera, with one district win on the season, they're down in the at the bottom of the district standings right now. Blaine, what are we looking for tonight? Victory.
We can pretty much secure our playoff spot by getting a big W tonight. We would have just enough games left and secure our spot. Caney Lake now currently in fifth place in district with 3-8 record. Fredericksburg in fourth, 5-6. Wimberley in third, 7-4. Davenport in second, 8-3. And Bernie in first place, leading the district standings at 9-2. Fredericksburg really with a pair of games in Bandera tonight. With our competition in fifth place, Canyon Lake playing Wimberley. We're going to be big Texan fans this week, even though that's who we are chasing in the standings.
Yeah, it's an interesting dynamic when four teams out of a 16 district are vying for playoff spots. You kind of have to pick and choose who you want to win, which week that benefits you, your team the most. Blaine, want to give a quick shout-out to our title sponsor tonight. That's Diamond W Specialties. Been with us here baseball season, all season long. We do appreciate them. Blaine, what can they offer up here to you, Diamond W Specialties?
Well, if your project is a new barn dominium or any type of metal building, Diamond W Specialties can take care of you through the entire build. Diamond W offers clearing, pad work, concrete foundations, and they specialize in spray foam insulation. With nearly 25 years of satisfied customers throughout the Hill Country, Diamond W is the right choice for your next construction project. Diamond W Specialties, metal buildings, and so much more. Contact them at 830-998-7377. Or DiamondWSpecialties.com. Diamond W Specialties, a cut above the rest.
Thank you, Blaine, for that fine
rendition of what Diamond W Specialties can provide for our listeners out there. As you can see, the Battling Billies are being announced onto the field. Bandera Bulldogs have already been introduced. We're getting closer to the first pitch. We're going to take a short break and hear from our sponsors, and we'll be right back with the opening pitch.
3 seconds on the clock. The shot's up for three. It's good, and the Billies win!
A successful fast break should end with a goal. Are your retirement plans and goals a slam dunk? Or does it need some more practice? At Joseph Financial Partners, we'll draw up a play to get you down the court and set you up for the win. We can't help you with your basketball game, but we can get your portfolio in shape for the championships. Call Joseph Financial Partners at 830-997-4763 or online at josephfinancialpartners.com. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC.
Strayer and Offers has been going strong since 1928. They specialize in tires and tire repair, wheel balancing, front-end alignment, brake repair, tune-ups, oil changes, belts and hoses, complete auto repair. Make sure you check out the Kawasaki mules and custom-built trailers ready to go to work for you. For quality Chevron products, Strayer and Offers, 509 South Adams Street, Fredericksburg. Call 830-997-4382. Check them out online, StrayerandOffers.com.
Ooh, man, you're playing like a new player since your hip surgery.
I'm telling you, Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine has changed my life. I lived with the pain of that old football injury for years. Never thought I'd walk right again. They did this minimally invasive procedure thing. Really sped up my recovery, faster than I ever imagined.
Man, I've been struggling with this old tennis elbow for years. I wonder if they could help me out.
Absolutely. They work wonders.
Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, getting you back in the game of life.
My name is Rick Barangi, and I'm the owner and founder of Long Neck Manor. I met Donnie several years ago because I was building a state-of-the-art barn for my giraffe, 10,000 square foot barn, and there's nobody in the area, not just Fredericksburg, but in the region, that could understand the complexities of building such a structure. Donnie's team is amazing. When they come out here, they're very professional, they're quick, they're thorough. You get a product even better than you expected.
Segner's Jewelers is a proud Battling Billy sponsor and big fans of our hometown team. Segner's has served generations of FISD families and friends and will be here to serve future generations. Located at 236 West Main Street, or find us on the web at segnersjewelers.com. We're with you all the way. Go Billies!
At the Real Estate Advisory Team, we know the Texas Hill Country, and we know Texas Hill Country Real Estate.
With the Real Estate Advisory Team, you'll have a team of experienced local professionals who value honesty and integrity and work tirelessly to help you achieve your real estate goals.
Give us a call or stop by today. We would be honored to help turn your Texas Hill Country dream into a reality. Go Billies!
Hello, my name is Greg Nebgen with 4N Cattle Company. I want to talk to you a little bit about J4 trailer and my experience. So I was looking for a new cattle trailer, stopped by, talked to Josh, customized what I wanted. I own a local business. I want to do my business local. Prices were very competitive. I looked at trailers everywhere. They were $1,000 cheaper, if not more. I was going to buy local anyway. They beat everybody in price. And then they even delivered it. J4 trailer, that's where I got mine.
And welcome back to Fredericksburg, Texas. Fredericksburg High School baseball field, Battling Billy baseball field. I don't think it has an official name, Blaine, does it? Maybe we should come up with one for this field. But as we sit here and look, national anthem has been played. Billies are out on the field. Harrison Langford going to be taking the mound tonight. He is getting set to throw his warm-up pitches. Let's see if we can get the defensive alignment made out here. Looks like Langford on the mound there, Blaine. We got Bowers behind the plate. Aiken is playing first. Spees at second. That's Wolf playing shortstop. We got Gaiman in playing third base. Threadgill's in center. He's flanked in right field by Nathan White, and Weston Herber is playing left field. The DH tonight is Fernie Ramirez, who is hitting for Weston Herber. So that's your defensive alignment tonight, Blaine. I'm glad we get to see Harrison pitch tonight.
Me too, because we haven't seen him in a while. He seems to always catch those away games. And so
It's
been a good, I guess, about month since we actually got to see Harrison throw a couple innings. And that's all it really was a couple innings. But he has really, really established himself as sort of our calm down, take out pitcher. The combination of, I think, him and Aiken pretty much shut down Canyon Lake about 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And so it is cool to sort of watch him pitch. He had a good win versus Wimberley a couple weeks ago, too. So awesome. Awesome to be able to see him pitch.
Yeah, well, everybody's set to go here as for the Bandera Bulldogs. Batting first is Jesse Cardenas playing first base. So... now, you're telling me in the standings, it seems like if we win this game, we're pretty much guaranteed a playoff spot.
You know, we got a two-game lead on Canyon Lake, and you sort of win this one. You go to 6-6, especially with the tiebreaker, with only three to play, with a two-and-a-half game lead like what we have. It would get to that point where it's – at least seal something for a play-in. Of course, the boys probably just don't want to barely get there. And so sort of as we go through, man, he mowed through that one really fast.
Three quick pitches, first strikeout for Harrison as he strikes out Cardenas. Up now for Bandera, Randon Wheeler, who's playing shortstop tonight. So not only can they play for, you know, this win here, but if they get, I think if they win three games, as Langford pumping them in there here, if we can win three of the next four, we have the potential to move into third, possibly second, depending on what Davenport does. We do play Davenport as Langford's just striping the outside corner there with that curveball. That's awesome.
I love to see
this right here. There's another curveball. There's a little fly ball right over center field. Threadgill ranging over makes the catch for out number two.
Well, and it's really, really where you catch them hot. You know, we caught Davenport when they were hot. And if we can get a little heat underneath our britches a little bit and in our bats, we can put some damage to Davenport. You know, it's all about the loss column is what it looks like, too.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you got tiebreakers against people. We currently do hold the tiebreaker versus the Texans. We took 2 of 3 from them. We won the first two. I said that on air last week wrong a bunch. I was corrected. we hold the tiebreaker against Canyon Lake also. So it'd be nice to actually hold the tiebreaker versus the Davenport at the end of the year. So
Langford quickly ahead here of Caleb Hohan, the catcher tonight. No balls and two strikes here with two outs. Throws a fastball in. Hohan fouls it back. So I think he wanted that one up just another half an inch, and he probably swings right under that pitch. And the 1-2, that's a curveball. Line drive up the middle for a base hit. So...
good piece of hitting there by, what would you say, Hohan?
Hohan.
Took a good curveball. I thought he really got that pitch down, but not down far enough. Maybe if he would have bounced that, might have been a little different being up in the count, but took it right back up the middle on a good inner half pitch. Got the base hit to get to Bandera, a base runner here with two outs in the first inning. Next up to bat, number 17, Payson Mangold for Bandera.
Yes, Kelton Rabb checks in as the courtesy runner for the catcher, Hohan. As Mangold will be doing the pitching tonight for Bandera as well. Langford quickly ahead, 0-1. Short lead at first for the Bulldog base runner over there, so it doesn't look like he's going to be going anywhere. Langford gets a strike in there. Ground ball right back to him. Little high hopper fields it on to first for out number three. Billy's coming in to bat. We'll be right back.
Top five reasons we love Gaddy's in Fredericksburg. Number five, their student teacher lunch discount. Number four, their all-you-can-eat buffet. Number three, they have a huge variety of fresh veggies at the salad bar. Number two, Gaddy's pasta and pizza is always hot and ready. And best of all, they even do the dishes. Gaddy's Pizza, Highway 16 South, across from the fairgrounds.
Security State Bank and Trust is a proud supporter of our local athletes. Whether it's on or off the field, game day or any day, they're here to help you succeed and tackle your financial goals. From personal and business banking to mortgage services or trust services, Security State Bank and Trust can support all your banking needs, helping build communities we call home since 1941. Security State Bank and Trust, proud sponsors of Battlin' Billy Sports. Let's go Billies! Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
It's grilling time at Hill Country Propane, Inc., and we've got the latest models of stainless steel grills made in America. Our showroom is full of grills by Wilmington, AOG, Fire Magic, and Phoenix. We offer Primo ceramic grills and pellet grills by Smokin' Brothers. Summertime is the time to celebrate grilling for family and friends. Come on in today and let our experienced team demonstrate features of the grill you deserve. Hill Country Propane, Inc. Go Propane.
Welcome to Creek Street Dental, where we strive to treat our patients with compassion, kindness, and care. We utilize the latest technologies in our commitment to your family, offering cone beam technology, cosmetic dentistry, and sedation dentistry so you can sleep through your appointment. Stop by and meet our newest addition, Dr. Monica Montgomery, from the Fredericksburg High School class of 2014. Creek Street Dental, on the corner of Creek Street and South Adams in Fredericksburg. We sure hope you're enjoying the coverage of today's game, and if you are, do us a favor, be sure and thank DR Welding. Quality and craftsmanship make the difference. Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, get your stride back. Arrowhead Bank, financial services for the Hill Country since 1923. Arizola Plumbing, the Hill Country's number one plumber. And by J4 Trailers, that's where I got mine.
Welcome back here as Colton Wolf for the Battle of Billies tonight steps in. He'll be facing Payson Mangold, the pitcher for the Bandera Bulldogs tonight. First pitch, fastball right on the outside corner for strike one. Mangold, a left-hander out there.
That's a good take.
Sometimes these lefties can give you fits. Blaine. You know, because yeah. That's what pitchers do when you're left-handed.
Is that what you did to people?
Usually. That was my goal anyway. There's a ground ball over to short. Up with it. Makes a throw. Nice,
that's a play, nice
play there by the shortstop. That's Brandon Wheeler. Getting Wolf out at first on that 6-3 put out. Brings up Asher Gaiman, senior third baseman for the Billies. What's he hitting?
Asher has actually raised his average to 307 this year. He has 19 RBIs, 16 runs scored.
I know he has at least one home run, maybe two. Does that say on there, home run?
Yep, it does. Two, you were correct. Yeah. He had a towering shot last game.
He also had that triple to right. I mean, we've seen him hit it over the scoreboard here in one game, and then another game he hit it down there into that right field corner, so he's hitting the ball all over the field, which is what you like to see from a high school hitter. There's a swing and a miss. One ball and two strikes. So Mangold looks kind of sneaky fast playing to me. He's not throwing that hard, but I think it probably looks harder than it is. He does a good job of hiding the ball.
His delivery is real unique. He sort of uncoils that arm.
Yeah.
And it almost looks like a snake coming at you striking.
Yeah, he's coming right over the top, and he hides the ball real well, which means the hitter's doesn't have as much time to see the ball coming towards him at home, which is an advantage for the pitcher. So two balls, two strikes. Here we're in the bottom of the first. No score. Mangold throws that one up high.
Good job by Gaiman here, battling to get to a full count.
Yeah. And there's a swing and a miss for a strikeout for out number two here. As Mangold, just like Langford, got through these first two hitters. See if the Billies can get something going here. Drake Threadgill stepping in, the center fielder tonight for the Billies. There's a swing, foul ball. There's another foul ball, so Mangold quickly. Hope I'm saying his name right. Mangold, does that sound right?
I hope it is.
Quickly ahead, 0-2 here on Threadgill.
Seems like he's real comfortable out there on the mound. I'll ask my information guru over here if that's who pitched against us in the first game.
I don't think it is.
Nope. Because I think the first game we went, I believe it was 10 innings against him. Yeah. Okay.
So two balls, two strikes now to Threadgill as Mangold brings a high inside fastball, gets the strikeout of Threadgill. That's two strikeouts in the inning for Mangold. That's going to do it for the first inning. 0-0. We'll be right back.
One phone call to Bee Creek was all it took, and our speeds crazy fast. Bee Creek Communications, always on high-speed internet.
Arrowhead Bank is celebrating 100 years of serving the Hill Country. Their goal is to greet you by name when you walk in the door and provide you the banking help you need today. You're guaranteed to speak to someone you know when you pick up the phone. Arrowhead Bank wants to thank all the employees of Fredericksburg ISD. Good luck to the Battling Billies in all activities this school year. Arrowhead Bank, 502 South Adams, 830-990-9300. Check them out online, arrowheadbanktexas.com.
All of us at FBG Live want to thank you for tuning in today. Lots of you have asked how you might support our video production. Well, if you want to grow your business, we know just the place to advertise. But here are three other super simple ways anyone can help. First of all, just tap the like button on this video. That helps us reach a broader audience, which in turn helps our sponsors who make it possible for you to watch.
Secondly, subscribe to our channels and tap the notification bell so you get alerted whenever we go live. And finally, and most importantly, patronize our sponsors. Shop at their stores, enlist their services. Heck, if nothing else, just give them a call and tell them thank you for making it possible for you to watch today. It is a joy to serve our community through live video production, but we couldn't do it without you or without our sponsors. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
And we're back as Lane Bourgeois steps in, hits a ground ball to the second baseman, Reed Spees, who's up with it and over to the first.
Great job there by Spees. Ball took a bad hop there at the end, but sort of just bounced in his chest right in front of him. He sped everything up a little bit, but then made the play at first.
That brings up number 8, Benton Clute, playing third base tonight for the Bulldogs. As Langford quickly in there, he lifts one out into center field. Threadgill over, couldn't quite get there to it, and Clute gets a single here with one out in the top of the second. No score. Brings up number 14, Brady Tressel, playing second base tonight. Blaine.
That ball came, it looked like slow off the bat, you know.
Yeah.
Just sort of hung on that wind, got yep. knocked down a little bit.
Yeah, we got the traditional straight in from left field wind, kind of from left field foul pole over to the right field foul pole. So anything out to left is going to get hung up by that wind, which I agree that ball there that Clute put in play, it kind of hung up in the air a little longer than probably Threadgill expected. And but he played it on a bounce. One ball and no strikes here to Tressel. Nipping on that outside edge just a little bit too far, Blaine.
Yep. Got to come to him now, 3-0. Definitely don't want to have too many base runners. Good pitch there on the outer half.
Yep.
Got to split the plate here now.
As Langford brings it in there, that's a strike two. So two balls, two. Oh no, he's saying 3-2. The umpire is. I thought it was 2-2. There's a fastball. Snap throw over to first. He's back in there, but that's a strikeout for Langford. His second of the evening.
Good job to come back, battling back from a 3-0 count there. Harrison really just sort of bared down, threw three really good pitches there to blow it past the batter to get the second out of the inning. Let's see if we can get out of this inning unscathed.
West Clute up to bat now for the Bulldogs. He's playing left field. Langford brings a couple fastballs in there and gets ahead quickly ahead 0-2 here with two outs in the top of the second. Oh, it's 1-1. And there's strike two. One ball and two strikes now on the batter. As Langford comes set, checks the runner. Strike three called right down Broadway for out number 3. Billy's coming in to bat in the bottom of the second. I'm Peter Shandawa along with Blaine Hahn here on Billy's.Live. We'll be right back.
I didn't do that peek in. Oops.
Yeah. All of us at FBG Live want to thank you for tuning in today. Lots of you have asked how you might support our video production. Well, if you want to grow your business, we know just the place to advertise. But here are three other super simple ways anyone can help. First of all, just tap the like button on this video. That helps us reach a broader audience, which in turn helps our sponsors who make it possible for you to watch. Secondly, subscribe to our channels and tap the notification bell so you get alerted whenever we go live. And finally, and most importantly, patronize our sponsors. Shop at their stores, enlist their services. Heck, if nothing else, just give them a call and tell them thank you for making it possible for you to watch today. It is a joy to serve our community through live video production, but we couldn't do it without you or without our sponsors. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Fredericksburg has put its confidence in Security State Bank and Trust for over 80 years. And now that same honesty and integrity is available for wealth management. We're not so much about timing the market, but time in the market. Not chasing returns, but capturing them. And not just for the affluent either. We're here to help anyone with their financial goals. A custom portfolio product based on your plan, your goals, your purpose. Give us a call today, 990-7750.
And we're back live here. We're in the bottom of the second inning as Langford comes in here. Colton Aiken, the number four hitter for the Billies, playing first base tonight, is stepping into bat here to face Mangold. Billies need to get something going here. So Aiken ahead here, one ball, no strikes. Mangold was able to get through that first inning with just 15 pitches. Langford's made it through two innings with 26 pitches. That's right on track.
That's good.
Yeah. That's what you like to see. There's a ball outside as Mangold kind of stares in at the umpire after that one. He wanted a little
expansion.
Extra inch or two on the plate there. As he now just brings one right down the middle. So 3-1. There's a ball lifted out into right field. That's going to go foul. So 3-2. You know, you look at sometimes these pitchers and early in the count, they try to nitpick on the corners maybe and fall behind, and then he comes in here and throws two solid pitches. And then a lot of times you see him maybe throw two solid pitches to start out, get two strikes, then they start nitpicking thinking they can get the strikeout. You got to go at these hitters right off the bat.
There we go.
Every pitch as Aiken draws the walk.
And now a word from the FISD Education Foundation.
The Fredericksburg ISD Education Foundation wants you to know that every dollar counts. Give today at FISDKids.org.
As Aiken reaches first base on the base on ball brings up senior Reed Spees coming in. I think he's hitting over 300 as well, Blaine.
Yeah, Reed's hitting 324. He has really poured it on, especially since district play has started. He has scored 11 runs and hitting two doubles. Has also had eight base on balls. Really had cut down. It hadn't had many strikeouts at all since the district play started. Putting the ball in play and really doing a good job for us out there.
That's right, and tonight is senior night. And I was here before the game when they did the introductions, and part of that introduction was, what was your favorite Battling Billy baseball memory? Do you know what Reed's was?
What was that?
Getting to pitch one inning on varsity.
Oh, that's awesome.
And we saw that just the other night. So I think he got through the inning in four pitches as he lays one down the first base line.
That is a great bunt.
And that's going to be a base hit for Spees on the bunt.
That was perfectly placed.
Yep.
Especially for the defense that they had right there. They had pitcher covering first base side. Third base was sort of charging. They had the wheel on to the left. So pitcher had to cover that, and he just could not get there. Spees would have probably beaten that out even if he would have gloved it there.
Yep. So now Billy's in position here with the first two runners on and no out. Brings up Vernie Ramirez, and he's been swinging a pretty hot bat lately. He's been hitting the ball solid the last several games. And there is another solid line drive into right field as Ramirez singles.
Hey, get out of the way. Let's go.
Right. And that's going to bring up Harrison Langford.
Big spot here for Harrison. He can really help his own cause on the mound, even by lifting a good fly ball or getting a good solid base hit here. Really can play to run for the Billies.
Yep.
Looks like they're bringing in the corners, playing at double play depth up the middle.
Yeah, base hit to the outfield should get us two runs. Spees, I'm going to just throw it out there. He might be the fastest player on the team. He's playing second base. I mean, he's at second base and playing second base. So I have a feeling he's going to score from second base on a ball to the outfield.
That's a good take.
One ball, one strike here to Langford. Getting a hit for himself tonight. You always like that when pitchers get to hit for themselves, Blaine. And there he lifts one out into right center, and that's going to get in the gap and go all the way to the fence. It's off the fence. That's going to should be bringing home three runs as Langford's going to end up with a stand-up triple and a bases-clearing three RBI triple for Langford, Blaine. You said it.
That's a great piece of hitting. He really caught that ball well. Took it to where they weren't. Puts the Billies on the board. Scoring three, stand-up triple for Harrison Langford. Great job of hitting tonight.
That's right. So, yeah, he split those outfielders right in the middle, and when he hit that ball, as Brooks Zimmel is courtesy runner there for Langford, the pitcher, he's in at third. But like I said, he split that right fielder and center fielder, and that ball made it all the way to the fence. As Brett Bauer steps in the bat here for the Battling Billy is now up 3-0. As Mangold brings the first pitch. It looks like the Bulldogs are going to play in with just one runner on third base.
And they decided they got to cut off these early runs. I think we even figured out last week you can't let these games get out of hand. But Emil's going to score easily on that pass ball to put the Billies up 4-0 here early.
I'll take the run any time, but sometimes when you're in these, like, scoring frenzies and people are getting on base and, you know, you just scored three runs and now the bases are empty with no outs. It's almost like a fresh start for the defense. You know, I'll take the run, but sometimes it's nice to just keep someone on base and keep that pressure on. But see if Bowers can play leadoff hitter here.
Well, now with a 3-0 count,
yep,
he can be real picky and selective. Ball was a little up. Got the call, though, as a pitcher.
Yeah, not a pitch that you probably want to swing at 3-0. Not that easy to handle, that tight pitch. And there's a swing and a foul ball. So full count now to Bowers. As he's waiting, there's going to be a line drive in a center fielder. Center field plays it on the bounce as Bowers singles.
Great job by Bowers there, really keeping his nose down on the ball, driving that ball just left of center. But now with a courtesy runner, number 9, Jack Geoffrey.
Yeah,
running for Bowers.
Yep, in for the catcher there. So, and that brings up the number 9 hitter, Nathan White, playing right field tonight. Also a senior. There's the pitch. White squares around, takes strike one. As Flick's yelling out the number signs.
I still can't get used to that.
That's a
Sorry.
New thing. It's a new thing.
I just can't.
It's a new thing. They don't even give signs in college anymore. And there's a bunt down the first base line as that's going to be a single for White.
That is now 2 bunt singles the Billies have had tonight.
In this inning.
Perfectly placed bunts. Push both of them to the right side.
As a Bandera coach going to take a quick mound visit. Looks like he might be changing pitchers. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back.
Arizola Plumbing, your full-service plumbing provider for the Fredericksburg community and beyond. We have the tools and experience for comprehensive residential and commercial plumbing, including everything from water filtration to drain services for new construction or even remodeling. Have an after-hours emergency? No problem. Don't settle for less than the best. We're online at arizolaplumbing.com or give us a call at 830-998-4336.
Hello, friends. This is Shane Fronson from The Inside Story. We'd like to thank you, our Fredericksburg community, for trusting us with all your home decorating needs. Whether wood or tile floors, window treatments or wallpaper, vinyl plank or paint, for 43 years now, you've made us the number one rated store in the area, and we couldn't be prouder to back our Billies right here on Billies.Live. Thank you, Fredericksburg, for choosing The Inside Story. Drop by today and let us help make your house a home.
3 seconds on the clock. The shot's up for 3. It's good, and the Billies win! A successful fast break should end with a goal. Are your retirement plans and goals a slam dunk, or does it need some more practice? At Joseph Financial Partners, we'll draw up a play to get you down the court and set you up for the win. We can't help you with your basketball game, but we can get your portfolio in shape for the championships. Call Joseph Financial Partners at 830-997-4763 or online at josephfinancialpartners.com. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC.
Strayer and Offers has been going strong since 1928. They specialize in tires and tire repair, wheel balancing, front end alignment, brake repair, tune-ups, oil changes, belts and hoses, complete auto repair. Make sure you check out the Kawasaki mules and custom-built trailers ready to go to work for you. For quality Chevron products, Strayer and Offers, 509 South Adams Street, Fredericksburg. Call 830-997-4382. Check them out online, StrayerandOffers.com.
Ooh, man, you're playing like a new player since your hip surgery.
I'm telling you, Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine has changed my life. I lived with the pain of that old football injury for years. Never thought I'd walk right again. They did this minimally invasive procedure thing. Really sped up my recovery, faster than I ever imagined.
Man, I've been struggling with this old tennis elbow for years. I wonder if they could help me out.
Absolutely. They work wonders.
Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, getting you back in the game of life.
And we're back live here. Blaine and I are speculating on the standings of the district. As with its pitching change here, as Benton Klute moves in to pitch for the Bulldogs, and he'll face the leadoff batter. That is Colton Wolf. He grounded out to the shortstop his first time. We're going to dive into these standings at some point tonight. Hopefully the Billies can get a big, comfortable lead, and we'll have time to really talk about it as Wolf squares around and puts another bunt down.
That's going to be another base hit.
Yeah, 3 bunt base hits in the inning, all intended to be sacrifices, but all three turning into base hits as they were perfectly placed. Munts, Blaine.
Perfectly placed. Thank you for watching, coming and watching the game tonight. If you want to tap the subscribe button, you can always be notified of when we go live here on Billies.Live too. If you want to tune in tonight on any one of our two channels on Billies.Live, the softball girls are playing tonight. They are playing Bandera also tonight. They're currently up 12-0 on our main channel. And again, thanks for tuning in here on Billies.Live too.
Yeah, they're playing right down the street there as Asher Gaiman steps up to bat here. One of the top two RBI men for the Billies, batting now with the bases loaded and no outs. As it's a swing and a miss from nice little curveball there by Clute. So he's down 0-2 here, Blaine. We just need a little punch to the outfield, get another run home as Geoffrey's over there 90 feet away.
Big gap there in right center. Yeah. Another good gap or we'll clear the bases again.
You've got to believe that with Wolf running over there at first. He might be the fastest. They're all the fastest. It depends who's on base, who's the fastest.
I think you're right from what I've heard. You were correct a while ago that Spies is probably the fastest.
At least around the bases. Maybe not in that straight line 100-yard dash, but.
We got some younger kids playing baseball that are pretty fast on the track team too, on varsity track and stuff like that. But yet to be seen.
Yep. Well, speaking of track, they're going to be heading down to
Kingsville.
Kingsville on when is that? Thursday.
Thursday. They leave on Thursday. They run on Friday and Saturday. Good luck to Coach Jason Raymer and Coach Dan Aldridge. Coach Raymer's taking 19 boys. Coach Aldridge is taking 16 young ladies that are representing our school in a regional competition. Coach Aldridge is trying to go defend, I think, a regional title again, a team title, and trying to qualify some young ladies. And Coach Raymer's taking a big, huge group, has some top times going in there. We've talked a couple times this week between us three and. They've never had that big of a group in recent years, but they've worked real hard trying to get a good itinerary and having the kids enjoy a hopefully good weather on their trip down there.
Yeah, well, good luck to the track team. As while you were giving that little update, Gaiman flew out to center, and now Threadgill standing in. To bat here against Clute with one out and the bases loaded here in the bottom of the fourth. Billies have already scored four runs in the inning, trying to add on some more. Now, I had a small visit with Coach Raymer after the game the other on Friday, and he's real excited about this track track meet coming up, and he's got the hotels reserved, and he's got the rooms assigned, and he was really kind of excited about the 4x4 relay, and he's really hoping that they have a good showing, and he thinks they might be able to get down to Austin.
Well, they have a top they have a real good top time, and you never know what'll lay out. They gotta still run the race. I've been looking. I'm a little bit of a track nerd myself. I've been looking at little times, especially on the boys' side. And I know I think Jonah Green in the 800 too, and the girls have a lot of good times. Like Taylor Grona and Ryland in the 800, and a couple other AC in the mile and 2 mile, and you got a lot that can go right for the girls in both relays that they qualify to, or all three relays, I think. So there's a lot that could qualify for the state tournament or state relay track meet, and everything's happening pretty quick. It just goes boom, boom, boom in order. They haven't even played district tennis yet. I was talking to Coach King, and they got their district tennis meeting tomorrow.
Yeesh.
And so that's going to be super late this year.
as Colton Aiken steps in here after. Wait a minute. Didn't we have the bases loaded? Okay, so we kind of missed that one. We were talking about track too much. Nathan White scored on that base on balls. And there's a little ground ball over to the second baseman, makes a diving stop. But Wolf's going to score from second as he was stealing on the play. So that's the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, seventh run of the inning on the single by Aiken.
You know, and then we talk some other sports. Congratulations to Coach Tim Kamen and the boys' golf team. They had sort of back-to-back just banner days down in Victoria. They shot a 295 on Monday, and then today they shot a 286, which by
that's
all,
four golfers.
By all recollection, I think that's pretty much two school records, as what everybody else says, but pretty much back-to-back. After the first day, I got a couple texts saying, I think that's a school record. Well, then they go out today, and they shoot a 286. Which is like
nine strokes better.
Yeah, and that's only like six strokes over par for
total
the group.
Yeah,
and it's amazing. Shepard Finley was second overall as an individual, minus four on the 2-day total. Lincoln Stotts was fourth overall. He shot two under. Louis Melton was eighth. He shot six over. Cade Wilson was 19th. He shot 13 over. And Nicholas Mead was 48th, and he shot 29 over.
Those are two-day totals.
That's a two-day totals. I can't even shoot any on those higher scores. I can't shoot that in one day.
Blaine, I don't even think you can hold a golf club.
I can hold a golf club because I've done it before. It's been a couple years. When I get 4 hours, I don't go play golf anymore. I go to the ranch and do a bunch of other things, I think, now. That is amazing. So they qualified for the state tournament, which is here in a couple weeks. And
where is that?
That'll be, I'm pretty sure, around that Austin area.
Okay.
I mean, there's so many golf courses around there, and that's usually where they head. Luck to them. The girls also qualify for regionals, and they're playing tomorrow and the next day.
All right. Well, we look forward to seeing how good they do as Reed Spees steps in here. His second plate appearance here of the second inning. Here with just one out, he had a bunt single in the first part of this inning. And he is now finds himself with a full count with two guys on. And Spee's waiting. As that pitch goes behind him, that's ball four. So that's going to load him up here for the hot-hitting left-handed designated hitter, Fernando Ramirez, as they like to call him Fernie. I think on the team is kind of his nickname.
Fernie. It's nice. The boys will play April 29th and 30th at the Legends Golf Course.
Legends. Ooh. That's not going to be easy. There's a swing and a miss. Foul tip by Ramirez. Batting here in the bottom of the second for the second time. He singled his first at bat. Waiting. That's going to be ball one. So one and one here. Yeah, the Legends. Isn't that out there close to Horseshoe Bay?
Yeah, I think it's Kingsland area.
Kingsland. From what I understand, that's a fairly difficult golf course.
It's on beautiful Lake LBJ.
Yeah, on the Lake LBJ out there. And Yeah, those will be some super fast greens and what I would call narrow fairways, if I'm not mistaken. But good luck to these guys. They've shown there that, I mean, when you're only 9 over par over 2 days with 4 golfers combined,
just
impressive.
I think they were 13, but they ended up winning by 31
shots.
That's just impressive at a regional golf tournament. They led out a 15-shot lead after day one, and then they just extended today.
That's 8 shots per player. So
it was sort of fun. They have a thing called Golf Genius.
Golf Genius,
and you can actually watch the round. I guess you could say I'm putting my air quotations up in the air.
Air quotations.
That you can watch. They somebody must be following them, putting their scores in. It's like watching online on the Masters. And so, it was sort of cool to watch them today. I would go and run some errands or do some stuff at school. And then I come back into my office and just sort of hit the refresh screen, and it refreshes automatically. And you just watch the boys and watch their scorecards.
There's a swing and a miss by Ramirez.
It was sort of interesting just to sort of see how good a day they were all having.
As Harrison Langford steps in here with the bases loaded for the second time, in the second inning, he tripled his first time up this inning.
We could really help his cause by doing. I think I said that earlier this inning.
You did. And with Spies at first, he might. Aiken better get on his horse because Spies might catch him if he gets one down in the corners or something. Spies looks right. Oh, the first baseman sneaking in behind him. Wouldn't surprise me on a back pick right here. That's ball 2.
Hey, middle of the way, let's go.
As Langford steps in there. He's ready. Klute on the mound, already thrown 26 pitches here in relief in the second inning. There's that back pick we were talking about, Blaine, but Spies was back.
Sneaking back over there. You said he was sneaking back for some reason. He's trying to signal his catcher, I guess.
Well, that's kind of a risky play with the bases loaded. I mean, if you make a bad throw, that's 2 runs.
That is true.
So, I mean, but when you're trying to get out of an inning, and there's a high fly ball to left field. Left fielder ranging back, makes the play for out number 3. Langford put a little charge into it. Wind was blowing the wrong direction, held that sucker up. So that's out number 3, but not before the Billies score 7 runs to take the lead, 7-0. We'll be right back.
My name is Rick Barangi, and I'm the owner and founder of Long Neck Manor. I met Donnie several years ago because I was building a state-of-the-art barn for my giraffe, 10,000 square foot barn, and there's nobody in the area, not just Fredericksburg, but in the region, that could understand the complexities of building such a structure. Donnie's team is amazing. When they come out here, they're very professional, they're quick, they're thorough. You get a product even better than you expected.
Segner's Jewelers is a proud Battle and Billy sponsor and big fans of our hometown team. Segner's has served generations of FISD families and friends and will be here to serve future generations. Located at 236 West Main Street, or find us on the web at segnersjewelers.com. We're with you all the way. Go Billies!
At the Real Estate Advisory Team, we know the Texas Hill Country, and we know Texas Hill Country Real Estate.
With the Real Estate Advisory Team, you'll have a team of experienced local professionals who value honesty and integrity and work tirelessly to help you achieve your real estate goals.
Give us a call or stop by today.
We would be honored to help turn your Texas Hill Country dream into a reality. Go Billies!
Hello, my name is Greg Nebgen with 4N Cattle Company. I want to talk to you a little bit about J4 trailer and my experience. So I was looking for a new cattle trailer, stopped by, talked to Josh, customized what I wanted. I own a local business. I want to do my business local. Prices were very competitive. I looked at trailers everywhere. They were $1,000 cheaper, if not more. I was going to buy local anyway. They beat everybody in price. And then they even delivered it. J4 trailer, that's where I got mine.
Top five reasons we love Gaddy's in Fredericksburg. Number five, their student teacher lunch discount. Number four, their all-you-can-eat buffet. Number three, they have a huge variety of fresh veggies at the salad bar. Number two, Gaddy's pasta and pizza is always hot and ready. And best of all, they even do the dishes. Gaddy's Pizza, Highway 16 South, across from the fairgrounds.
And we're back live here as Cooper Gunderman stands in. He swings at the first pitch, and that's a line drive to right field. Nice play by White to make the catch out there.
It's a really nice play.
Yeah, baby.
Thought he had a pretty good bead on it, and then flailing a little bit to his left, but came up, but gloved it. Great job by White getting the first out of the top of the third for the Billies.
Jesse Cardenas steps up. He struck out his first time on three pitches. He swings at that first pitch. He took three pitches the first time, and now he's swinging at the first pitch. Is Langford really busting in the strikes for the Billies here tonight? Here's another ball lifted out into right field. White is over and makes the one-handed grab. We're out number two.
Another play by our right fielder. Good job by White, ranging over. High looping ball hit to him. He ranged over pretty easily, caught that ball. Two outs for the inning. Langford rolling here in the top of the third.
You know, that's one thing that's changed, Blaine, in baseball. The fielders now field everything one-handed. If you watch college, professional, most high schools, everybody's taught now to field ground balls one-handed. You catch fly balls one-handed on your glove side.
Right.
That is kind of the new thing. Now, the old school, as Langford's three-pitch strikeout there of Wheeler to end the inning. We'll be right back, and we'll touch on these new ways of fielding a little bit more, Blaine. We'll be right back.
Security State Bank and Trust is a proud supporter of our local athletes. Whether it's on or off the field, game day or any day, they're here to help you succeed and tackle your financial goals. From personal and business banking to mortgage services or trust services, Security State Bank and Trust can support all your banking needs, helping build communities we call home since 1941. Security State Bank and Trust, proud sponsors of Batlin Billy Sports. Let's go Billies! Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
It's grilling time at Hill Country Propane Inc., and we've got the latest models of stainless steel grills made in America. Our showroom is full of grills by Wilmington, AOG, Fire Magic, and Phoenix. We offer Primo ceramic grills and pellet grills by Smokin' Brothers. Summertime is the time to celebrate grilling for family and friends. Come on in today and let our experienced team demonstrate features of the grill you deserve. Hill Country Propane Inc., go propane.
Welcome to Creek Street Dental, where we strive to treat our patients with compassion, kindness, and care. We utilize the latest technologies in our commitment to your family, offering cone beam technology, cosmetic dentistry, and sedation dentistry so you can sleep through your appointment. Stop by and meet our newest addition, Dr. Monica Montgomery, from the Fredericksburg High School class of 2014. Creek Street Dental, on the corner of Creek Street and South Adams in Fredericksburg.
Usually six runs is a lot of runs. And we're back live here. Fredericksburg. We're talking about SEC baseball, during the break there. So that's what we were talking about on the way back. But Brett Bauer's up to bat. And Blaine, we were also talking about that one-handed fielding that is taught now as Bowers takes strike one. You were mentioning that it seems like the error count has gone up since that new way of fielding is.
I don't know.
Well, especially at this level. I mean, it's probably a little more difficult for these high school level players to field those the balls one-handed the way they teach them now in college and pros. So that could, I think he got something going on there.
Maybe, maybe not.
All right. Well, we'll find out. As Klute now finds himself behind Bowers. Two balls, one strike here. We're in the bottom of the third.
I guess my argument is when you only go one-handed to something, like we were talking about ground balls in the infield, then you have a tendency to field outside of your body. Yeah. And when you do that, then you're not, to me, you're not getting your body in position. And so if a ball, you are going to get a bad hop, then you won't have a chance to let that ball then fall where it needs to. Like the last half inning was a prime example for Spies when he got his whole body in front of a ball way to his left, took a bad hop, came right off his chest in front of him, and then he was able then to still field the ball and make the play. And so,
yeah,
that's my opinion. But
I don't like it either.
I just used to coach. I don't coach anymore, and so.
Yeah. As Bowers draws the walk, Geoffrey comes in as the courtesy runner for the catcher Bowers, and so Geoffrey over at first base as number 15, Nathan White up to bat as Klute tries the pickoff move. Geoffrey back. Nathan sacrifice bunt single his first time up. See if he's doing it again. Takes strike one. As Geoffrey getting a little bit bigger lead this time. I don't suspect he'll be going anywhere. That's ball two. Or is that ball one?
Ball one. 1-1. Did a pickoff move and two pitches.
Okay. And there's a ground ball between third and short. Finds left field for another single for White. And I know this game isn't over by any stretch of the imagination, but Billy's already have 8 hits, and that's kind of what you were alluding to. If we can get this week and kind of get these bats with a little more confidence going into that last week against Davenport, and if we're only 2 games behind them going into that, you have a chance to move yourself right into second place with a sweep of Davenport next week.
Totally agree.
So if I'd like to see these guys keep the bats free swinging. Keep the base hits a-coming. As Wolf lifts one to left field towards the scoreboard, left fielder ranging back, could not quite make the play. And Wolf gonna come in with a stand-up double with an RBI. He got a hold of that one, Blaine. That was into the wind.
Into the wind. Really made that left fielder look a little awkward trying to run back to play that ball. It sort of got over his head. Good job by Wolf giving that ball a good ride.
Yep. And now Gaiman with another RBI opportunity. He's one of the top dogs in RBIs for the Billies. So we're hoping he can get us a hit out there into the outfield.
To add to his 19 RBIs on the year with a 307 average going into tonight.
And there's a ground ball past the third baseman, and that's going to be out into left field, and that is going to get two runs home. Gaiman going to make it into second base with a double as he hits that ball right down the third base line, leading two runs. That makes the score 10-0 Billies here. Billies now with 10 hits on the evening. As Drake Threadgill steps in, he has struck out and walked.
Drake's our leading average guy on the year with a 371. He also leads the team in RBIs with 21. He has 27 walks on the year.
I think people have been pitching around him. He's also hit two bombs that I know of. I don't know if that's there.
Two.
But one of them went about 432 feet over here the other night.
Nine doubles, one triple, two homers on the year.
Okay, well, he's got an opportunity here with Gaiman on second for an RBI. There's a backdoor curveball. That's a good take there with 1-0 count. You're not going to. That was a well-placed breaking pitch.
That was.
As Threadgill's waiting, Clute checking on Gaiman at second. There's another curveball dropped in there for strike two. That one was a little bit more hittable. Let's see what Clute decides here. I'm guessing he's going fastball. Let's see if Threadgill guesses the same. If he gets one he can handle and he's looking for it, he could give it a ride here with this wind blowing from left field over to right field. Went with another breaking pitch, yep. So what do I know?
Maybe now. 2-2. We'll challenge see. Him. Don't let it get to full. That's what I would do. No, I'm not going to say stuff like that.
Clute checking on Gaiman. Here's the pitch. That's a fastball up and in. So three balls and two strikes here. Still no outs. We're in the bottom of the third. Billy's already scoring three runs in the inning, taking that 10-0 lead. There's a ground ball to the first baseman who takes a funny bounce, and he misplayed that as Threadgill going to reach on the error. And Gaiman's going to move up to third base on that play. Brings up senior Colton Aiken. As Aiken steps in, he is 1-for-1. He walked and singled in the second inning. And there's a ball ripped out into left field. That's going to be down for a single as Gaiman scores. And Threadgill moves up to second base. Reed Spees now going to get a chance to bat. He is 1-for-1 also with a single and a walk in the second inning. So there in that second inning, Billy sent 13 men to the plate, scored 7 runs here in the third inning, have already sent seven men to the plate, scored four runs. SB's swings and misses at that first pitch.
Got a couple of district game updates. Top of fifth, Davenport 0-2, Bernie 0.
Uh-oh, Davenport up.
Davenport just scored their two runs is what it looks like. And then in the top of the fifth at in Canyon Lake, Wimberly 1, Canyon Lake 3.
Yeah, Roskin, that's that pitcher there from Canyon Lake. He can beat anyone in the state of Texas if he's throwing that curveball the way he threw it against us that first game. That's going to get 90, 95% of high school hitters out. I don't care how good they think they are.
So really tight games in district play tonight.
Ski's reaching for that. That's going to go out of play. Yeah, so that makes things even more interesting. We speculate all we want, but we'll know for sure tomorrow morning.
And in a couple of innings, possibly.
So it's interesting to speculate on these things. Umpire talking to Coach Flick on the third base side there. Flick letting the dugout know something. They might have said something they shouldn't have. So I don't know if they were maybe saying something to the Bandera players, because now you can physically hear them saying.
There's a base knock. Ooh.
Oh, he almost
that was a nice
play
by
that.
The shortstop.
Yeah. As he gloved it and tried to flip it to the second baseman with his glove, but that didn't work. So that's going to be a single.
And another run scored by the Billies to bring the score to 12-0 FHS over Bandera.
Yes, Threadgill scored on that play, on that flip. The ball got away from the second baseman there, so that enabled Threadgill to score. As Ramirez now steps up to the bat, he's 1-for-2. And he stands in, swinging a hot bat last five games. He's really put the ball in play hard.
He really has, and man, he gets that bat head going through the zone. I'd be scared as the first baseman playing that far up.
Yeah, or being the pitcher. He almost hit one of them pitchers the other night.
Yeah.
With that line drive up the middle. Yeah. Ramirez, he's waiting. He's got Aiken on second here with no outs. Spees on first. There's ground ball foul. He was chomping at the bit to swing that. He was waiting. Is that an old-fashioned term, chomping at the bit? Does anybody even know what that means?
I do. He's ready to go.
You know, it's a horse terminology. Spee's got a big lead over there at second. I wonder if they'll try to backpick him. That's ball two. Now this tennis you were saying, which doesn't start till next week, district, that's individual, right?
It singles, is. So singles, doubles, mixed
doubles. Okay.
So.
And you just basically the districts play a tournament?
District play a tournament, and you get two entries of each. Top two go on.
So there's six districts.
16,
I mean,
six teams
in the district.
And you got to win first or second to go on to regionals.
And how many singles players from each team?
Everybody enters two.
Two?
Yeah.
So there's 12 singles.
Single elimination.
And they're playing
to win.
To get into the championship. And if they make, there's a hit by a pitch for Ramirez, that's going to load up the bases for the Billies. So you're basically, they have to draw, I'm assuming, on who gets the bye.
They do a seed meeting is what they do. is what it's called. So they look at records, they look at experience, and they seed the top four. Looks like Bandera is going to do a pitching change. While they're taking a break and doing their pitching change, we'll take a break and we'll be right back after these messages.
One phone call to Bee Creek was all it took, and our speeds, crazy fast. Bee Creek Communications, always on high-speed internet.
Arrowhead Bank is celebrating 100 years of serving the Hill Country. Their goal is to greet you by name when you walk in the door and provide you the banking help you need today. You're guaranteed to speak to someone you know when you pick up the phone. Arrowhead Bank wants to thank all the employees of Fredericksburg ISD. Good luck to the Battling Billies in all activities this school year. Arrowhead Bank, 502 South Adams, 830-990-9300. Check them out online, arrowheadbanktexas.com.
All of us at FBG Live want to thank you for tuning in today. Lots of you have asked how you might support our video production. Well, if you want to grow your business, we know just the place to advertise. But here are three other super simple ways anyone can help. First of all, just tap the like button on this video. That helps us reach a broader audience, which in turn helps our sponsors who make it possible for you to watch. Secondly, subscribe to our channels and tap the notification bell so you get alerted whenever we go live. And finally, and most importantly, patronize our sponsors. Shop at their stores, enlist their services. Heck, if nothing else, just give them a call and tell them thank you for making it possible for you to watch today. It is a joy to serve our community through live video production, but we couldn't do it without you or without our sponsors. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
As we're back live here, Harrison Langford stepping into the plate here with the third time with the bases loaded. As not many times that you get to come up to bat in one game with the bases loaded three separate times.
Three separate times. And what has he done?
In three innings. Three of those times.
What has he done all three of those times?
We don't know about this time yet. The second time he flew out to deep left field.
Oh yeah, he was trying to go. He was trying to go Jose Canseco on the second time.
Yep, he's down in the count 0-2 here, so needs to shorten up here, just get a ball in play up the middle, get another run home for the Billies. Langford waiting, and there's that ball up the middle. Shortstop unable to get to it. That's going to be a single. Trying to make a play at the plate. And he's going to be out at home.
That's a very awkward slide.
Spies.
But we did score a run.
We scored one run. Spies gets thrown out at home. So that's the second out of – no. Is that the first or second? So first out of the inning is made at home base.
I think that's the second out of the inning.
No, that's only one. No, that's one out. I got the book right here.
Oh, yeah?
Nobody's out.
Okay.
So that went from the center fielder to the... with runners on first and second. Well, I'm having to scratch out all the inning numbers here. But this is on the right score tab this time, right score page.
It's fine here
when it's the Billies scoring 13. And I'm now making the fifth inning the third inning.
That's good. I like that.
So Bowers, the 10th Billy to bat here in this inning. He walked to lead this inning off. And there's a ground ball to the first baseman who comes up with it and throws to second to get the out. Nice play there by the first baseman. So that was 3-6. Fielder's choice, run scored. No run scored. We got runners on first and third now as Brooks Immel comes in to courtesy run.
I think it's Jack.
That's Brooks. No, that's Jack.
It's Jack.
Brooks is running for the pitcher. As Nathan White up to bat. He's 2-for-2 on the evening. There's a ball into Sticker Hill. As there's two kids waiting over there for it. They're picking the stickers off it right now. They're going to start playing with that thing once they get the stickers off that thing.
They're pitching over there. One of them's catching, one of them's pitching. That's the norm over there.
And there's another foul ball on the right side. As White now, no balls, two strikes here, two outs. We're in the bottom of the third. Six runs in on the inning, 13 for the game, 12 hits.
Great piece of hitting tonight by the Billies. Yep. They've really been comfortable at the plate all night, doing a really good job with runners in scoring position.
That's right. That's what you like to see. I mean, you get the base runners on and when it's almost like in these games, Blaine, you know, when you get those first couple of runners in scoring position and you get that hit, it's like a big sigh of relief for the whole team. And everybody relaxes, and then hitting with runners in scoring position all of a sudden becomes just a little bit easier.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely. And I think it all kind of started there when Langford hit that triple with the bases loaded. That kind of was like a big sigh.
Well, you know, it sort of sets the tone. You know, we didn't play well on Friday. We couldn't score many runs. It was late when we finally did score a couple. And that really, really got everybody super relaxed. And you can tell everybody's approach tonight has been very aggressive and very just offensive-minded, I guess you could say.
That's right. Now, the other half of that whole thing is, the pitching we're facing tonight isn't quite as good as the other night, but we weren't facing the dominant.
Uh-oh.
And that ball gets all the way out into center field.
That's going to score two.
Yeah, as Geoffrey now is going to score two. Yeah, that might be frowned upon there by the opposing coach, Blaine. I don't know about that stealing here, up 13-0. It's not always like the proper etiquette thing to do, but Billy's scoring two on that play. You can never score too many runs.
No.
Right. I mean, you never know what can happen.
Good pitch.
And that's going to be strike three called for out number three. That's going to do it for the third, but Billy's up 15-0. We'll be right back.
All of us at FBG Live want to thank you for tuning in today. Lots of you have asked how you might support our video production. Well, if you want to grow your business, we know just the place to advertise, but here are three other super simple ways anyone can help. First of all, just tap the like button on this video. That helps us reach a broader audience, which in turn helps our sponsors who make it possible for you to watch. Secondly, subscribe to our channels and tap the notification bell so you get alerted whenever we go live. And finally, and most importantly, patronize our sponsors. Shop at their stores, enlist their services. Heck, if nothing else, just give them a call and tell them thank you for making it possible for you to watch today. It is a joy to serve our community through live video production, but we couldn't do it without you or without our sponsors. We hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Fredericksburg has put its confidence in Security State Bank and Trust for over 80 years. And now that same honesty and integrity is available for wealth management. We're not so much about timing the market, but time in the market. Not chasing returns, but capturing them. And not just for the affluent either. We're here to help anyone with their financial goals. A custom portfolio product based on your plan, your goals, your purpose. Give us a call today, 990-7750.
What is the FISD Education Foundation? Since our inauguration in 2018, the foundation has financially supported teachers and students from all our campuses achieve academic excellence. Our fundraising efforts help offset the adverse effects and depletion of resources brought on by state Robin Hood policies. Visit FISDKids.org to learn more. The FISD Education Foundation, partnering with our community because we're better together.
Okay, we're back live here as Langford back out there for the fourth inning. He's going to be facing Hohan, who singled his first time up, right back up the middle. So... had a couple of score updates there, Blaine. Canyon, what's happening?
Canyon Lake's up 5-1 over Wimberley now.
There's a fly ball to right. Nathan White under it. Makes the one-handed grab for out number one.
And Davenport is also extended to a 5-0 lead.
Over Bernie.
Over Bernie. Yeah.
Which is a surprise to me, but it's baseball. Anybody can win any game. I do know the pitcher from Canyon Lake, that Roskin kid. If he's on, he's hard to hit. So I'm assuming he may have pitched. Does it say who's pitching?
I'll see in the next half.
Next half, okay.
In the next half. I'm sort of watching both games on the Game Changer app. I'm a fan. Both teams is what they call it. So you can actually sort of watch, but not 100%. I know both teams are sort of going through, and you can watch. I think Canyon Lake has a broadcast. I don't know if Wimberley has their broadcast, but I know Canyon Lake does a broadcast too. And I've been trying to look those up. Getting some scores fed to me tonight by Coach Raymer. I know he's watching scores also. So.
As Langford strikes out Mangold for the second out, that's 5 strikeouts for Langford on the evening. As Lane Bourgeois, the right fielder, steps in, he grounded out to second base his first time up. Langford starts him off with that outside. That's a patented first pitch strike there for Langford. Fastball outside corner. Almost every time.
Almost every time.
There's another fastball. So he's ahead 0-2. I just elevate up just a little bit more with the fastball, get a little swing and miss here, and go back to the dugout. He chose the breaking ball.
I don't know.
I'm just telling you. I'm just giving you my opinion here as a commentator what I think should happen. So
now a fastball.
Well, now up. As long as he gets it up.
Up. Nope, he threw another curveball.
Another curveball, ground ball.
Into the dirt. Gaiman comes up gunning. Aiken with a good tag to get the third out of the inning. As Harrison here completing 4 innings of pitching with only 44 pitches. Really in control with the Billies up 15-0. And we'll be back after these messages.
Arizola Plumbing, your full-service plumbing provider for the Fredericksburg community and beyond. We have the tools and experience for comprehensive residential and commercial plumbing, including everything from water filtration to drain services for new construction or even remodeling. Have an after-hours emergency? No problem. Don't settle for less than the best. We're online at arizolaplumbing.com or give us a call at 830-998-4336.
Hello, friends. This is Shane Fronson from The Inside Story. We'd like to thank you, our Fredericksburg community, for trusting us with all your home decorating needs. Whether wood or tile floors, window treatments or wallpaper, vinyl plank or paint, for 43 years now, you've made us the number one rated store in the area, and we couldn't be prouder to back our Billies right here on Billies.Live. Thank you, Fredericksburg, for choosing The Inside Story. Drop by today and let us help make your house a home.
3 seconds on the clock. The shot's up for three. It's good, and the Billies win! A successful fast break should end with a goal. Are your retirement plans and goals a slam dunk, or does it need some more practice? At Joseph Financial Partners, we'll draw up a play to get you down the court and set you up for the win. We can't help you with your basketball game, but we can get your portfolio in shape for the championships. Call Joseph Financial Partners at 830-997-4763 or online at josephfinancialpartners.com. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC.
Because then the most we're back live. We're talking standings again here. We got caught talking about it as with these new little things that are developing with Davenport over Burney, 5-0. Wimberley, Canyon Lake over Wimberley, 5-6-1 now. That throws a little wrench into our hypotheticals from earlier in the game. We might have to go through a new set of hypotheticals, Blaine. Who is this? Colton Wolf up to bat here for the Billies to lead off the bottom of the fourth.
The biggest thing is if we try to go get second place, if we want to try to go get second place, if Davenport goes and
wins tonight,
beats Burney even once or if twice, then they're going to be out of reach for the Billies.
Yeah.
And so
they have to lose both their games for us to have a shot to Burney.
And sort of how you look at that, you sort of, you know, first places play fourth places in the district across from us. And I think that's District 28 4A. And so you look at the first, second, third place, fourth place. I do believe the team that's leading that district is Lavernia. Lavernia's leading that district. And then Navarro. Gonzales.
And Cuero.
Cuero.
It's only a 4-team district, I think.
And so you just sort of look at that and
you don't want to play
somebody
the
top one because they're the best one in that district. Just like nobody wants to play the top one here, but we are pretty evenly matched, and I think we've had a tough road, and we've sort of proved in our district anybody can beat anybody any one night.
That's right.
So,
especially with a good pitching performance, I mean, if you can locate and bring him, there's a drive out into right field that might get over the right fielder's head, and it does. Gaiman's going into second base here with a one out double here in the fourth inning.
You know, and now UIL did sort of make a new rule this year that you are playing 3-game series. Unless it is agreed that you're going to play one.
Both teams have to agree to it?
To play one. It's
both
not
teams.
The other way around, where you're playing one and you have to agree to play three. It's the now you are playing a 3-game series.
And both teams have to agree to play once.
Yes. I know they definitely said that for the upper levels of.
There's another drive out the right field. Right fielder back, though, makes a play on Threadgill's fly ball. Gaiman tags up. Moves over to third on the fly out to right field by Threadgill. Two outs in the inning now. Well, that's interesting.
Somebody was telling me about that the other day. I haven't looked that up, but that'll be interesting to sort of hear about and see how the spacing of all these, the postseason is then.
Yep. Colton Aiken steps in here with Asher Gaiman on third. As we are looking out there into center field, and I see the new middle school. Aiken waiting. There's strike one.
Gonzalez, Squero, Kennedy, and Memorial. Kennedy and Memorial round out that district. Kennedy is actually in
this. Is Cuero in the district?
Cuero is.
Oh, so they have six teams.
They have six teams. Oh. Kennedy and Memorial. Kennedy's in the mix right now for that fourth place spot with Cuero. They're both at 3-4. Gonzalez is also at 3-4. But Navarro, 5-2 right now. Lavernia, undefeated in district play, 7-0. 16-7 overall. Navarro, 18-5 overall. Pretty good. Pretty good record for a yearly record. Good block by the catcher there.
Yeah. Three balls and one strike here to Aiken. He is 2-for-2. He's walked and has two singles, both infield singles.
Good call. It is Roskin pitching for Canyon Lake.
Yeah. Luke Roskin is the kid's name. I remembered him from the first district game way back, I think, on March 12th. And he threw a dandy complete game against the Battling Billies, and he had that curveball busted in there. And there's strike three called to Aiken. That's going to do it in the bottom of the fourth. Billies up 15-0. We'll be right back.
Strayer & Offers has been going strong since 1928. They specialize in tires and tire repair, wheel balancing, front end alignment, brake repair, tune-ups, oil changes, belts and hoses, complete auto repair. Make sure you check out the Kawasaki mules and custom-built trailers ready to go to work for you. For quality Chevron products, Strayer & Offers, 509 South Adams Street, Fredericksburg. Call 830-997-4382. Check them out online, StrayerAndOffers.com.
Ooh, man, you're playing like a new player since your hip surgery.
I'm telling you, Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine has changed my life. I lived with the pain of that old football injury for years. Never thought I'd walk right again. They did this minimally invasive procedure thing. Really sped up my recovery, faster than I ever imagined.
Man, I've been struggling with this old tennis elbow for years. I wonder if they could help me out.
Absolutely. They work wonders.
Texas Hill Country Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, getting you back in the game of life.
My name is Rick Barangi, and I'm the owner and founder of Long Neck Manor. I met Donnie several years ago because I was building a state-of-the-art barn for my giraffe, 10,000 square foot barn, and there's nobody in the area, not just Fredericksburg, but in the region that could understand the complexities of building such a structure. Donnie's team is amazing. When they come out here, they're very professional, they're quick, they're thorough. You get a product even better than you expected.
Segner's Jewelers is a proud Battle & Billy sponsor and big fans of our hometown team. Segner's has served generations of FISD families and friends and will be here to serve future generations. Located at 236 West Main Street, or find us on the web at segnersjewelers.com. We're with you all the way. Go Billies!
At the Real Estate Advisory Team, we know the Texas Hill Country, and we know Texas Hill Country Real Estate.
With the Real Estate Advisory Team, you'll have a team of experienced local professionals who value honesty and integrity and work tirelessly to help you achieve your real estate goals.
Give us a call or stop by today. We would be honored to help turn your Texas Hill Country dream into a reality. Go Billies!
Yes.
I totally agree with you.
On Friday, he should have.
On Friday, he should have.
Yes. And against Bernie.
And we're back live here, Battling Billies. Up 15-0. New pitcher on the mound is Brett Bowers. He's a senior. So have you looked at the stats? Has he pitched this year?
Let's see.
I'd be curious about that because it's interesting, you know, because last game on Friday, the senior Reed Spees got to pitch an inning, and it was the thrill of his life. So his most memorable Battling Billy baseball memory of his career, and I would say that Bowers, he probably pitched in tournament time though, maybe a little bit.
You can maybe go,
yeah, see there. We're gonna look it up. Bowers starts it out with a strike.
I do not see his name listed under our pitching stats.
Okay, so this is his first outing of the year here on senior night. So Gaiman is now behind the plate. Diego Guevara has moved to third base and entered the game. There's strike two. Ahead in the count, 0-2. So Bowers just looks like a natural out there on his first outing of the year on the first two pitches.
Rock and fire.
That's what I like. As Gaiman going to call a timeout and make sure they know what the signs are. That's catcher on catcher there. So he's just making sure he doesn't want.
He goes, okay, if I touch my head.
Yeah, he doesn't want to cross up. As Bowers tries the off-speed pitch just a little bit inside. Working here with a 15-run lead in the top of the fifth. Billies need three outs to end this game with the 10-run rule in effect. I'm just going to go ahead and talk about it, Blaine.
That's cool. That's just great.
And there's a swing
chuckle,
and a miss
chuckle,
for
chuckle.
Strike three as that's Bowers right. strikes out Clute. So if Bowers can complete this inning here without giving up a run and maybe get a couple of strikeouts, if he could go back there on senior night and talk about his most memorable Battling Billy baseball thing, he might say pitching an inning two, pop up to the first baseman Aikman, who makes the two-handed catch, Blaine.
That was nice.
For out number two.
It was nice. I like that second hand up there.
Yeah. That's how we used to play back 35 years ago. You know, we're
back
old geezers now.
You had to hitch the wagon to the horses to drive to school and everything. And
We're old geezers. You gotta know that. Bowers out of the windup. Strike one. He's up 0-1. In the count, there will not be a post-game show. I do want to give another shout-out to Diamond W Specialties for the sponsorship tonight and all season long. There's a curveball for strike two. No balls and two strikes here.
Little
Bowers trying to complete this final out of this game. And just high. I thought he was going to throw all strike. Well, no, he did throw one. He had one ball to that last batter, or the first batter. I was thinking 8 pitches, 6 strikes so far. There's strike three. That's going to be 9 pitches, 7 strikes, 2 strikeouts in the inning. Might be Bowers' new
closer role.
Well, it might be his new favorite memory of Battling Billy baseball. And, yeah, he's coming in here in the last inning, getting the final 3 outs of this ball game. Billy's with 13 hits, 15 runs. Let's go over to the Game Changer app and see if we can get a, before we close out the broadcast for tonight, we're going to try to update these scores real quick. But Blaine's trying to look that up. It's
Davenport is now up 12-0 on Bernie.
Yep, so that game is in hand. So Davenport's going to win that. Going to make it extremely difficult there for the Billies to come in second place with that score. And Canyon Lake still leading 6-1 over Wimberley. So
and has a runner on third in the bottom of the sixth, up 6-1 with Roskins on the mound still.
Yeah. So Billies take care of business tonight, 15-0. All they can do is take care of themselves here, play Bandera on Friday night. Then next week, 2 more games left in the regular season against Davenport. So Battling Billies win.
We will actually be on air next Friday to end district play here at the ball field here in Fredericksburg. If you want to come out for the last district ball game or tune in live on Billies.Live.
That's right. Well, that's going to do it for the broadcast tonight. I'm Peter Shondawa, along with Blaine Hahn and the entire Billies.Live crew, saying God bless and good night.